Okay, quick little New York story. One of my favorite iconic pieces of New York gear, accoutrements, is the as essential is the $5 umbrella. You guys know what I'm talking about. They're not made very well. They have the life expectancy of an overweight poodle in downtown Manila at dinner time. They're not gonna be around very long. But every once in a while, you'll score a good one. And I had a I did. And when I say a good one, it does what it's supposed to do. The little metal spines actually go into little plastic tips at the end of that are sewed onto the nylon and don't keep popping out. And it opens and closes and it locks and the handle stays on. And if somebody sneezes 10 feet away, it doesn't turn inside out like it just hit a tornado. And I had one of these things. I treasured this thing. I had this thing for about 3 years, sort of like, my trusty little sidekick, my little good luck charm. So I have my umbrella. I'm going out one night to do comedy, Upper West Side. I'm in Brooklyn. I'm on the F train. It's pouring rain. It's been pouring rain. Feet are wet, everything else dry, because this umbrella did its job. I'm on the train, and somebody has left in the seat next to me a New York magazine, and there's an article about the umbrella you must have this season, and it's like some $3,500 repurposed Ipe handle, waxed linen, bespoke umbrella from Barney's and Bergdorf Goodman for the merely 30. You must be seen with it, even on sunny days. And it's just ridiculous. I'm just reading this thing about this umbrella, and happy to have my little $5 one. And I get to the club, and there's a comedian on stage before me, this guy named Brian, very funny, doing a bit about umbrellas. So I'm like, this is like there's umbrellas in the air. I'm thinking about the magazine thing. He's talking about umbrellas. I go on, I do my thing. Show ends. We got another show afterwards. So we're sitting at a little table, just chilling, having some drinks or whatever, talking. I'm talking to him about his bit. It's a very funny bit. And a lady comes over. And there's something off about this lady. This lady from the audience, as they're she breaks away from the people leaving to come over to talk to us. And in New York, you're so used to crazy people. I mean, you see them walking down the street, like the overtly crazy people that are like, and you're like, look at that guy. Had a little too much coffee. But you also have the you also get develop like a sixth sense for people who are just kind of low-key insane. They have these little just little signs, And this lady came over and she starts asking us the same question over and over again. She's like, "Excuse me, I had a really, it was very funny and everything. I just have a question. Where does the comedy come from?" And as she's asking that question, I see her. She puts her arm on top of my wet umbrella, which is laid on the table, and her arm is just soaking there. She doesn't remove it immediately like a normal person would. She just leaves it there, marinating in the rainwater, right? And I kind of make a little mental note of that. And so I start answering the question. It was directed to me first, and I said, "Well, you just you observe things around you, and you sort of translate them through your comedic lens." And she's like, "No, that's not what I'm talking about. But where does the comedy, where does it come from?" And I'm like, "Well, there are different sources of inspiration. I mean, you'll see things, that'll be one, and then you also there's people who could sort of invent scenarios." She's like, "No, you're not listening. You were very funny. Where does the comedy?" She asked this Brian guy, "Where does the comedy come from?" And it's just a little uncomfortable, at this point. We're kind of trapped there. She's kind of blocking the escape route. And so he starts to answer, and he's like, "Well, there's different types of everybody's got a different process. I get up, I write." She's like, "No, I'm not talking about your writing, what you write, but where does it come from? Where does it come from?" For the fifth time, "We get it, we get it. Where does it come from? Right, we get it. We're trying to answer, whatever." So we're trying not to be annoyed, and I don't know. It was just a really awkward exchange, and we weren't giving her whatever the information was that she needed to, satiate her desire to know, about the combustion of comedy. And she just finally, she's like, "Ah, that," and just walks off, right? And it was just a very weird, intense exchange. It got very intense for a second, and it was just very strange. So I'm looking at him, and we're talking about him. I'm like, this is just very, what a weird. And he's like, yeah, it's almost like she didn't want us to answer the question. She wanted something else. And before he can finish the word else, I look down. My umbrella's gone. This bitch has stolen my umbrella. And that's New York, you know? You got to keep your friends close. You can't keep your good $5 umbrella much closer. And I don't know if we'll ever answer the question about, well, where does comedy come from? But it always seems to come when you're not looking.